Good morning, boys and girls. Today is Sunday, April the 14th. Welcome to our kids' worship. Whether you've joined us at main campus, up at Gormley, or you're watching this online with us, I just encourage you to stand with me as we use our voices to worship God this morning. Just as I am.
Are his people and he is our king. We are one body, we are the church, and we'll share the gospel throughout the earth. We will go now. We have been sent out. This is where the mission begins. Filled with God's power, the Spirit now within us. This is where the mission begins. To tell about Jesus, we'll go to the ends of the world. This is where the mission begins. This is where the mission begins. Can stop us. Our God is with us. Boldly we proclaim. Salvation has come to those who call on Jesus' name. Nothing can stop us. Our God is with us. Boldly we proclaim. Salvation has come to those who call on Jesus' name. This is where the mission begins. Filled with God's power, His Spirit now within us. This is where the mission begins. To tell about Jesus, we'll go to the ends of the world. This is where the mission begins. This is where the mission begins.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just continue to think of you and think of your grace and your love and your salvation plan for each and every one of us coming out of the Easter weekend. As we continue to journey with the disciples, with the remaining time they have with Jesus on the earth, Lord, may we continue to learn more about our response to your love. So continue to be with us as we worship you this morning. And we pray all these things in your Son Jesus' most, most precious name. And all of God's people say, Amen. Good morning, boys and girls. It's Pastor Stephen here. Today again is Sunday, April the 14th. I'm happy to have you. Hopefully you're happy to see me, and I hope you are enjoying the warmer weather we're getting as we move from winter to spring to summer. We are at a point in time where the disciples are super excited that Jesus is alive again, and they're hanging out and they're spending time with him. But for some of them, they still need to go over some of the things that happened before Jesus died. For example, do you guys remember what Peter did before Jesus died? He did something three times. And today's story is about how Jesus responds to that situation to teach Peter a lesson, but perhaps also to help us remember a lesson when we mess up, when we screw up, when we sometimes do things that we're not supposed to do. So, with that being said, I want you to check out this video from our story out of John chapter 21.
Three days after Jesus died on the cross, he came back to life. More than once, Jesus appeared to his disciples and proved that he was alive. One day, Jesus met his disciples while they were fishing on the Sea of Galilee. Peter and the other disciples got into a boat to go fishing. They spent all night on the water, but they did not catch any fish. The next morning, as the sun was coming up, Jesus stood on the shore. He called out to the disciples, but they did not recognize him. Jesus said, "Men, you don't have any fish, do you?" "No," they answered. "Put your net in the water on the right side of the boat, and you will catch some fish," Jesus said. The disciples did what Jesus said. So many fish were in their net that they could not pull the net back into the boat. One of the disciples said to Peter, "It is the Lord." Peter jumped into the water so he could swim to shore. The rest of the disciples traveled to the shore in the boat, pulling the net full of fish behind them. When the disciples got out of the boat, they saw bread and a charcoal fire with fish on it. "Bring some of the fish you've caught," Jesus said. So Peter pulled the net ashore. It was full of large fish, 153 of them. "Come and have breakfast," Jesus said. Jesus took the bread and gave it to them. Then he gave them the fish. Jesus turned to Peter. "Do you love me more than these?" he asked. "Yes, Lord," Peter said. "You know that I love you." "Feed my lambs," Jesus told him. Jesus asked Peter again, "Do you love me?" "Yes, Lord," Peter said. "You know that I love you." "Take care of my sheep," Jesus said. Jesus asked Peter a third time, "Do you love me?" Peter was very sad that Jesus asked him a third time. Peter loved Jesus very much. "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." "Feed my sheep," Jesus said. Jesus told Peter that he would bring honor to God. Then Jesus said to him, "Follow me." The disciples had turned away from Jesus when he was arrested, but Jesus still wanted to use them in God's plan, as fishers of men who would tell people the good news about Jesus. Jesus is the Lord who forgives us and makes things right again.
Hey boys and girls, it's Pastor Stephen here and welcome back. Before we go back to our story with Peter and Jesus, let's go over what our big picture question and answer are supposed to be that we're exploring this unit. Our question is, of course, how do we know that God wants us to know him? And our answer is that we can know that God wants us to know him because he has revealed himself through his word being Jesus. Our memory verse, again, is from John chapter 17, verse 3, and this is what it says. "Now, this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent." Let's read that one more time. "Now, this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent." I think something very important for us to learn from Peter's experience is that even though sometimes we may mess up, sometimes we may break and forget God's commands, and sometimes, like Peter, We might even deny knowing Jesus. It's important for us to know this, that we are part of God's plan, even though we sin. Yes, some of you, if you've accepted Jesus into your heart, we have Jesus in us, but we unfortunately will still sin here and there at times, sometimes when we expect it, sometimes when we don't expect it. But we are still sinners and we are still full of sin. God, nonetheless, will use people like Peter, someone who denied him three times, and people like you and me to do what he wants us to do. Whether that's to share the gospel with our friends and families, to care for those in need, to love our neighbors as ourselves, no matter what we do in terms of sin or how we sin. Of course, it's important for us to remember to ask God and seek his forgiveness, but God will still use us as sinners as a part of his plan. So don't be afraid when you hear the Lord telling you to share the gospel, to love somebody, to care for somebody, or to be able to speak up, to defend the poor, to defend the widow, to defend the homeless. May the Lord give you the courage, the strength, and the wisdom to do so. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you that even though we are so inadequate, that we have sin in us, and there's not a lot we can really do on our own, Lord, that you still love us and you still use us to further your kingdom, and you still use us to do the things you want us to do for you. So as we worship you in our lives, through our actions and through our words, may you give us those words to say and those actions to take so that we reflect who you are to the people around us. Because these things we pray in your Son, Jesus Christ's mighty name, and all of God's people say, Amen. Boys and girls, let us rise today to receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord turn his face towards you this week and bring you peace. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us this week. We look forward to seeing you next week with none other than Pastor Amy. Bye.